Hare Krishna. Welcome to the Nectar of Bhagavad Gita as it is by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare
Today, we will understand text numbers 36, 37 and 38 of chapter number 1, Observing the Armies on the Battlefield of Kurukshetra. Text number 36.
Papameva shraed asman hatvaitan atatainaha tasman narhavayam hantum dhartarashtran sabandhavan svajanam hi kathahatva sukhinaha shyamamadhava.
Sin will overcome us if we slay such aggressors. Therefore, it is not proper for us to kill the sons of Dhritarashtra and our friends. What should we gain, O Krishna, husband of the goddess of fortune, and how will we be happy by killing our own kinsmen?
Purport.
According to Vedic injunctions, there are six kinds of aggressors. 1. A poison giver. 2. One who sets fire to the house. 3. One who attacks with deadly weapons. 4. One who plunders riches. 5. One who occupies another's land. And 6. One who kidnaps a wife. Such aggressors are at once to be killed, and no sin is incurred by killing such aggressors. Such killing of aggressors is quite befitting any ordinary man. But Arjun was not an ordinary person. He was saintly by character, and therefore he wanted to deal with them in saintliness. This kind of saintliness, however, is not for a Kshatriya. Although a responsible man in the administration of a state is required to be saintly, he should not be cowardly. For example, Lord Ram was so saintly that people even now are anxious to live in the kingdom of Lord Ram, Ram Rajya. But Lord Ram never showed any cowardice. Ravan was an aggressor against Ram because Ravan kidnapped Ram's wife Sita. But Lord Ram gave him sufficient lessons unparalleled in the history of the world. In Arjun's case, however, one should consider the special type of aggressors, namely his own grandfather, his own teacher, friends, sons, grandsons, etc. Because of them, Arjun thought that he should not take the serious steps necessary against ordinary aggressors. Besides that, saintly persons are advised to forgive. Such injunctions for saintly persons are more important than any political emergency. Arjun considered that rather than killing his own kinsmen for political reasons, it would be better to forgive them on grounds of religion and saintly behavior. He did not therefore consider such killing profitable simply for the matter of temporary bodily happiness. After all, kingdoms and pleasures derived therefrom are not permanent. So why should he risk his life and eternal salvation by killing his own kinsmen? Arjun's addressing of Krishna as Madhav, or the husband of the goddess of fortune, is also significant in this connection. He wanted to point out to Krishna that as the husband of the goddess of fortune, he should not induce Arjun to take up the matter which would ultimately bring about misfortune. Krishna, however, never brings misfortune to anyone, to say nothing of his devotees. Text numbers 37 and 38.
Yadyapi ete na pasyanti lobha pahata chetasaha kulakshaya kritam dosham mitra drohe cha patakam katham na Niyam asmabhihi papat asman nivartatum kulakshaya kritam dosham prapashyadbhir janardana.
O Janardan, although these men, their hearts overtaken by greed, see no fault in killing one's family or quarrelling with friends, why should we,
who can see the crime in destroying a family engage in these acts of sin? Purport: A Kshatriya is not supposed to refuse to battle or gamble when he is so invited by some rival party. Under such obligation, Arjun could not refuse to fight because he had been challenged by the party of Duryodhan. In this connection, Arjun considered that the other party might be blind to the effects of such a challenge. Arjun, however, could see the evil consequences and could not accept the challenge. Obligation is actually binding when the effect is good, but when the effect is otherwise, then no one can be bound. Considering all these pros and cons, Arjun decided not to fight. This brings us to the end of text number 38. Thank you very much.